Glory! I saw y'all on channel 3. I mean, can I give God a clap? We're about to get some good representation at East NUA. I mean, I'm just sorry in my district. This is going to be good. It's all always been in the sending vote. I am no friend. Thank you, brother. Yeah. Yes, you are. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. I just want to make sure Chip could hear me.
Yes, sir.
I just want to make sure. Listen, my name is Louis, and I get the ultimate opportunity to represent District 3. And District 3 is very important to me. What the citizens of District 3 say is my job to advocate for that. And so tonight is not an opportunity for me to lend an opinion other than that hopefully my record clearly indicates that I've always supported what my constituents said. Whether it's my belief or not, the people that elect me, I work for them. So I'm going to continue to work for them and advocate for them in the best way possible. So, before we bring up our county administrator, I do want to thank Jeff Dollar and Jerry McGuire. I've known Jerry for many years. I am a contractor, full disclosure. But to come out and do a public meeting to try to explain, doesn't necessarily mean I have to agree with anything anybody says. But certainly you have to recognize and respect when a business owner will come out and take out your schedule to at least express their ideas and exactly what they want to do for a neighborhood. And I think the people who pay taxes and support whatever on your neighborhood, I look the way you want your neighborhood to look. We're never going to censor the opportunity for economic growth in our county, but we certainly want to have responsible growth and responsible economic development. So with that said, my job tonight is to do a little listening. I'll be honest with you, we have a Jacqueline Newton staff. We have a lot of staff that I rely on heavily, other than when Gloria writes a letter, and supersedes staff. But my daughter is playing basketball at West Florida. And I love being a commissioner, but I love being a dad most. So I'm going to stay here as long as I can to listen. But certainly staff will report back to me if I have to learn. So thank you for being here. Thank you for being concerned about District 3. If I don't get an opportunity to come out and meet you and knock on your door, I am very, very thankful for the things that you do for our community.
My name is
Lumen May. I'm going to say that again because you may have another election. I need you to vote. My name is Lumen May. County Commission, District 3, absolutely. Jack, with that being said, I'll introduce our county administrator and he'll introduce our staff. And we have a great staff, and the technical part of this, in the regulations and ordinances, typically are recommended to our board by these people that you see in the room, and they have expertise. They've gone to college and they've had training. And I respect what they say, but none of them really vote for me unless they live in my district. So I respect people who vote for me more than I respect their effort. So again, with that being said, Jack, you got it.
Since when you turned it over to me, I'll use the microphone now.
Well, no problem.
We'll start. I want to also introduce Lumen's aide, Aretta Green, who keeps Lumen going from place to place. He's got a very busy schedule, and she keeps him on track and helps interface with me so that I know where he's at, so I can contact him. We've got Casey Lagarde from our community media support here tonight with us, and we have Meredith Crawford from the county attorney's office. Next to her is Matt Coughlin, who's assistant county administrator. And then we have Chip Kirschenfeld, who's the director of environmental services. Then we have Brent Wythe, and we have Tim Day, with environmental. And then we have Horace Jones, who lives in the area, and of course is the director of developmental services. And with Horace, he's got Juan Ramos in the back. And we've got Andrew Homer, I think that's all the staff. So this is a time for us to come out and listen to you and get your input on projects. And, the county commission and Escambia County probably has more outreach than any county that I'm aware of in 20 years I've been in local government. So it's a great opportunity for you to have your voice heard, and we appreciate the contractors being here with us tonight to discuss their project with the community. So with that, I'll turn it over to Jeff or Jerry.
Thank you very much, Jack. My name is Jerry McGuire. I am the consultant engineer who worked with Mr. Godwin. Mr. Godwin is actually the owner of Delta Contractors and all. You got anything bad to say to him, you got a good thing to say to me, okay? Maybe that's where it was, where I started. But Jeff came to me a couple of years ago and said, Jerry, I'd like to start a concrete and asphalt recycling facility. And it'd be a piece of property up on the drawing right here in the car if you want to take a look at that. And also on the table over there is a copy of the development order, a copy of the operations permit, and also a copy of the actual permit for the facility itself. And we started out on a process with the county staff, a lot of them just heard about and all. You look at these folks all the time, they're good folks, they're very stringent, they don't want you to violate anything, I'll say that for sure. That's their job. And Jeff had a piece of property and got some industrial property, so it's good for this type of development. And we permitted the project actually back in 2016. And it was already a concrete facility. Just be the old
sign. Can you speak up so we can't hear you?
Oh, you can't? Can you hear me now? Okay, yeah. Yeah, used to be the site, it's a pipe company for years, half on one side of the interstate, half on the other. So it kind of lent itself to this. It was already selling industrial, like I said. So we went through the process, we got the development order back in early May of 2016. From that point, the project went to the Board of County Commissioners. We did have at that time a public hearing before the board, and brought a few folks out. We got some good input, and that's what we're looking for this evening. Also, if there's anything you want to bring up and talk about, you're welcome to do that. If you can't answer the question, then maybe go back to something the county staff or get one of them to come up here and also help do this presentation on. So the operation was approved, Jeff started work, and if you look at the operations plan, which is sitting up there, there's a bunch of copies of it. He's allowed to work from Monday to Friday, 6 to 6, but I think his development order says actually from 7 to 5, and then about 6 hours on Saturdays, okay? Primary purpose is people bring in demo concrete and asphalt from building, roadways, whatever. Jeff has a machine that takes and recycles that, crushes it up. It's a very quiet machine to go out and get next to it. That's always one question people have, how loud is it going to be? And it's fairly quiet and all that. And so he has his hours by the development order and by the permit that he has to work in. He gets outside of those and gets in trouble. Yeah, not now, like I said, he hasn't worked in less and all that. So a lot of monitoring goes on this site as far as the process, as far as airborne particles, any water contamination that may get out and all. Brent Whip and the chips over there, we keep an eye on that. They're very good at what they do. I don't know of any potential problem they've ever had out there, but there's always a chance. And we need to keep on top of that so that we don't get into a problem with anyone, especially the county or you folks and all that. So that's kind of where we're at. It's about a 6-acre site. What now is going on is Jeff is actually fixing to renew the permit. I'll be renewing it for Jeff. And the whole idea is do this on a yearly cycle. It's kind of a quick turnaround for a permit, but the standpoint is it gets it out there so you folks can take the time. If you see an issue, you see a problem, you bring it up. And this is just going to be an open forum. And you're welcome to ask any question you want. We try our best to answer that question. If you don't know the answer, we'll find somebody who does and all that. But this is Jeff. I don't know if you want to say anything or not. Not at this time, okay? Yeah, you keep your work and not talking a lot. So, that being said, I'd like to open up the floor. I'd like some folks, if you'd like to ask some questions, be about the operation, the facility, boys in this way, that's fine too. Since a big chicken head, and y'all all welcome to speak, okay? And if you're welcome to come up and speak from your seat, whatever you'd like to do. Yes, ma'am.
You're saying it's quiet machine. Yeah. It is not.
It's not quiet. Like the sheet. Yeah.
It is not quiet whatsoever.
Yeah.
I'm right in front of that place.
Yeah.
And I'm rolling up from like 6 in the morning, and they're saying that not there on Sundays. I have to pull my back garden, and they're out there on Sundays.
We don't work on Sundays.
Well, that's my day off.
That's my day off.
You may not be there, but someone else is there, because I can hear it. It's very loud. So as for the quiet, as you say, it is not quiet at all. It shakes my house. It rattles my house. I feel like I'm scared for my foundation because it's so loud and the way it rattles. So I'm not understanding where you're getting the quiet from. It's not quiet whatsoever.
Yeah. Yeah, I think there are noise standards that have been checked as far as the machine and all those, and then fall within the guidelines for the machine and the county and all that. So it may be a potential problem. They can move that machine around inside the track of the vehicle. Maybe that is closer toward the residents in Woodfield, so it is on the south side, correct?
Yeah, that's why.
And all that. That may be the issue.
Jared, excuse me one second. Jack or code enforcement? I mean, what number do we have for people to call if they say that it's being done on a Sunday? I mean, is there a number that she can call on a Sunday? Do we have a number?
Yes, because I Googled.
I mean, and he says it's not. I'm not arguing one way or other, but there should be a number in which she can call. Yeah, there should be a number that she can call on a Sunday to report this.
Yeah, there's a number out on the front sign. There's a number right there on our sign out front. There's a problem. You can call me directly. But I'm telling you, I'm not trying to speak with you, argue with you. We do not open on Sunday. Those gates do not open. Not me. I've been there 2 years. I've been there 2 years. We don't work on Sundays. The last 2 years, we worked 2 Sundays and not there. For one, our development order will not allow it.
Well, I actually have videos of how loud it is.
And, okay.
So it's very loud.
As far as knowing at 6 o'clock in the morning, we don't start work till 7 o'clock. Our gates don't even open till 7.
You got to hear that all day long.
We don't crush every day.
So you're saying most of the time that it's not loud over there?
We do not crush every day. Last week, we crushed one day. Last week. This week here, we have not crushed. We have not crushed at all this week.
But you crush it
every single day.
So before we leave tonight, please get us your address, and then we can show you what those sound levels are.
Secondarily, my name is Tim Day, and the code enforcement does report to me. So if you call me directly at 595-1144, we can arrange to get people to come visit off hours. For example, if you're saying they're firing at 6 o'clock every day, I can arrange to have something. You know, if I'm working on weekends, we can arrange to have something. But if code enforcement is a kind of reactive process, we respond to complaints. Please feel free to utilize this. And you know, we'll respond and confirm if they're inside or outside of the permit conditions.
Do you have a number again, Tim?
It's my direct number is 595-1144.
Yeah, it's, I mean, we, the poor,
that on Sundays, Tim, as well?
Yeah, it's, I pick up 7 days a week.
Good.
And what is
the house?
It's operator error. So, once again, my name is Tim Day. It's T-I-M, D is in David, A-Y. My direct number is 595-1144.
This is my first interview. If you can't hear me, you're really not. You need some hearing aids.
Yeah.
Okay, I was here a year ago when y'all was trying to get this permit. I was against the PIM for this community, and I went out to the community and spoke to them. There shouldn't be a concrete crushing site in the backyard of any neighborhood.
Amen.
Sadly, our county commission has been hoodwinked for years of allowing these things to go in communities. It shouldn't happen, and they should move or move the people. These are wonderful homes these people have. Now, I want to ask about the hours of operation, because I know that they're supposed to be from 8 to 5. I know it's only supposed to be 8 to 3 on Saturday and never on Sunday and never on holidays, unless there's an emergency. Can't imagine there's an emergency at a concrete crushing site. At the beginning, when y'all said last year when you wanted this permit, you said you'd only be crushing twice a week. I've been out there several times, you're crushing all the time. Here's the other issue. You're not to be, no landowner should be able to see any of your debris above fence line. That concrete crushing mound is at least 50 to 60 feet over the fence. I can see it. Oh, I've got pictures, Hoss. You can laugh all you want, but it's not your health. It's not your home. It's not your property value.
I'm there.
Okay?
I'm there.
Hey, you're not living there. Settle down, Hoss. This is us. No, you've got to address these regulations. All right, where's your runoff pond? In the back. Where? Where? Show me. Show me. Show me. When you crush concrete, what is the rule, Chip? Water on the concrete to keep the dust down. That water's supposed to go somewhere. Where is it going? I don't see a pond. Hey, that's right. So that's against regulations right there. That's why we're shutting this one down or moving it over here because it's next to wetlands. No. This is the public talking. Okay, hours of operation, height of the mounds. How many air monitors do we have out there, Chip? You put up a finger. None?
We don't have any permanent monitors.
Ah, so the health, according to this, sampling and monitoring is to take place.
But we do go out and we monitor when they start crushing at the very beginning.
At the very beginning.
Correct.
But you're not there 7 days a week when they are crushing. Okay, I'd like to see the sampling and the monitoring reports. Let's see what else is here. It says the permit does not relieve the permittee from liability upon the danger of human health, welfare, animal, plant life, property. Let's put some earthquake monitors on these homes and see what they rattle like. We've got to, county commissioners, we've got to get these things out of people's backyards. We've got to. There's no water pond on here. Boom. Out. Let's go to furthermore. Hours of operation. You want to give me that, Tim? What? Because I know out here it's 8 to 5. And we've got 7 active landfills and 1 concrete crushing site.
According to the development order of our house.
Oh, would you like that 6 to 6 in your house? How would you like to wake up at 6? These homes were there first. So, I promise you, we will all be at the county commission, along with the Wedgwood residents, to talk about concrete crushing sites in their backyard, and this one's not going to get a permit. I swear, I'll hair-lift the Pope to make this one stop. It's ridiculous that we allow this, our government allows this, and disenfranchised communities every time. Every time. It wouldn't be in your backyard now, would it? Would you like it behind your house?
No.
Yeah, no.
We don't care.
You don't care.
Yeah, because he's got this.
Okay, so we're going to stop this. You need to move. Just like the county commissioners right now are looking for a place to move Sunbelt, you need to find another place that's not behind people's homes.
Well, if they go to Marcus Point.
Yeah, go to Marcus Point. There you go. All right? But these are their homes.
They didn't want them over there because these are nice homes.
They are nice homes. They are great homes.
Yeah, but they live over there.
So get it out of the building. Get it out of the neighborhood. We've got government housing over here. How much wash and silica dust do you think is going over there? I'd like to know that about this for the children. What about all the traffic from these trucks and the children playing in that area?
Why don't they go north? It's far north.
Just as I say, the commissioners right now are working on a way to get Sunbelt Crushing out of here and move it up north. This one needs to move as well. There's no reason it should be next to a community. None. And you don't have a pump.
You're right about that. We do not have a pump. We were not required to put in a pond based on land development code. So it's not like anybody didn't, you know, review that. We did. There was no impervious area added. It was already existing on the site. As a result, there was no pond.
Are they grandfathered in? No pond? Oh, another grandfather clause on the backs of working class folks.
It's actually not a grandfather clause, but it's okay. Yes, sir.
Last year, I had 10 surveyors come by. They surveyed my property from all across the back. They were surveying and putting a hole in the pond, and they said they were hard to do it. So where did that go?
Well, it depends on what type of development we were doing and whether they were increasing the amount of the impervious area, hard surface. If they were, yes, they would be required to do that. That's correct. Yes, sir. So they should have put in a
pool.
Somebody
had authorized
it. We
have a
pool. Not there. Oh, it's not there? No. Oh, I'll Tim Bay, man. I don't know about that. I'm not
building
for
something.
You're
going to go out there and talk to folks and listen to the noise?
Yeah, I've been out there, sir. But you're talking about a different piece of property in the subdivision, is that correct?
You talking about Sunbelt Crushing?
Okay. Yeah, I don't know. They were out there taking elevation sites. Yeah.
We don't know about that. I'm not aware of the project. I wouldn't have to clue, to be honest. But if they have increased impervious area, they're still doing it. Back to the president. Okay?
So we have that there.
I've been living there for almost 2 years, and then the 1 year I was living there, I had a dog pass away. He was only 6 years old. All of a sudden, he got sick, and within 2 days, he's dead. Another thing, a year and an empire, this happened like 6 months ago from all the shaking and rattling. I had a gas leak because it completely broke my line. So I had to get that fixed.
No, so I'm not understanding how you would like that in your backyard. How would you put that in someone else's backyard?
This is gravity.
I
have a crack in my foundation because of all the shaking and
rattling. Yeah. Actually, I think what y'all are referring to is actually some of the other big equipment that moves around the site. Okay. The concrete, the things. And, you know, they do right. we are going to do that just by the fact that we clean everything and move it, and hardly surface it. So it's going to have some vibration to drive that.
Tim Brunson,
Maybe we can use the county funds again and put an officer there, 24/7, like we had to do at Bowling.
Who has the company? What does it need tall?
He can talk, he just...
You're not saying anything.
The permit does not constitute a waiver of approval of other federal, state, and other county permit or license.
He's not talking.
There's a state one.
It does not constitute a waiver.
Then ask for it, we got a permit.
Tim, I think they got a county license.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
They actually have a permit, you have the machine, not the site, when it comes to the state. Okay, so there's a permit on that machine itself to crush it. And that permit goes to the machine.
General permit condition on facilities.
I'm not exactly sure what you're reading.
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. It's your permit.
Yeah. Well...
I'm sorry you didn't read that there, Zach. There's number three at the bottom of the permit page.
Well, all that's saying is you got to do the permits if you're... That's all that's saying.
I'm not going to do this. I've been doing this for too long.
The point being is there's a permit for...
You gotta stop.
And all, so there are other permits to get that.
They're on the right one. And that's the truth.
I know.
And that's sad. But y'all are not telling me about it.
All right, is there any questions or other issues we need to discuss? Close it down, okay.
I'm putting your back there.
Okay, now to go to a different camera. That's fine.
That's all right, I can go to a different camera.
I have a borrow pit in my back there, so there you go.
And which borrow pit is that?
Over in San Rose, Bill Willis.
And who owns it?
Bill Willis.
Who?
Bill Willis, that has nothing to do with this meeting, by the way. That's all the track, so we need to stay on the track for this meeting, okay? But,
I'm not going to check out what's that landlord's.
You can come to the house, I'll take it later.
No, I don't have any.
Okay, very good. But anyhow, is there any more questions or concerns? I know we got the one on the no bomb, and talked to the county about that, monitors at the site, and talked with them before. Take a look at the silica that may be blowing around, make sure we're down below the levels. Hopefully to eliminate it and all that. And also a concern about homes being damaged and other things by the vibrations. What I'm trying to do is pare it down to what the comments I can address. As far as move away, missing mass, I can address.
The overall thing is like our own too.
Right.
I want to retire one day without being, that would be great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I understand what you're saying. But we don't know that, okay?
Yes, we do.
We're trying to get the point.
Look at any CDC report.
Okay, what we're trying to do is get constructive criticism and have to win that way. Because if you generate sometimes, we need to stay on track with the time to do it, okay?
Do some research on solar panels.
We will.
They write the value of it.
Any other items that we need to discuss here?
When they're out there in the crush or whatever, do y'all wear some kind of respirators, masks, do y'all wear anything while you're out there?
Oh,
so
yeah.
Y'all are breathing all that, right?
Yeah. Oh, you got good life insurance for yourself.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
I bet you he don't want to live in this city anymore.
Yeah.
He doesn't.
Well, you can imagine on his boots. I mean, what does that say where he's going to be completely?
All right, you got any other concerns or questions that we'd like to discuss?
Yeah, exactly.
Where's Ted somehow? It's fine. Must be fine.
Where?
That's how it would be at work. Is that all you can say is working?
Ted somehow.
Me?
We can do this, my young man.
What I was requesting the lady was saying, when they're crushing up the thing and stuff, they wear masks or anything?
That's what I was thinking.
Don't they?
They don't wear any.
Get your lawn, that's right.
You can put your concern on.
You can move.
Yeah, we'll add that to the list.
Don't go to the shower. This evening, and we're going to take to heart the facility. I don't think we want to work with the county on this. We're not lying, okay? There's no sense in saying that. The point being is the fact that, yes, ma'am. But anyhow, we're going to work on these issues. We'll address all these and go back through the development process to re up the permit. And if you have anything else you'd like to talk about, what we call county, what we call Jeff. We're on these actual permits, closing plans, and all that, so feel free to call, okay? All right, thank y'all very much for coming out this evening.